First, Bloomberg.
Welcome back. You are watching The Pulse. We are live on Bloomberg Television. We're streaming on your iPad and, of course, on Bloomberg.com. Talk of an attack on Syria has not gone unnoticed. Of course, in Israel, the two countries are still technically at war. And although Israel would be unlikely to physically take part in any attack on the country, there are concerns it could be sucked into the conflict. Anyway, for more, let's go to Tel Aviv and our Middle East editor, Elliot Gotkin. Elliot, we're starting to see some military movement. We're starting to understand how Tel Aviv is going to react to the ongoing situation. Let's get some analysis.
Thanks, Guy. Yes, well, here in Israel, there's been a government approval for a limited call-up of reserves, and reportedly another Iron Dome missile defence battery has gone up north to the city of Haifa. But to get more of an insight on what's going on here in Israel, I'm joined by Jonathan Speier, who's a senior research fellow at the Interdisciplinary Centre in Herzliya. Thanks for joining us. Yesterday, sure, an attack seemed inevitable and imminent. Today, it doesn't. What's your take?
Well, I think clearly what we're seeing here is the Iraq war syndrome to some degree in both France and the UK, two countries which fascinatingly have actually led the way in terms of holding Assad responsible for chemical warfare use, chemical weapons use, all the way back to April, who've led the way in researching that and finding out the details, now finding when it comes to their publics and their elected representatives, there's a great deal of reluctance when it comes to military action in the Middle East. So France saying now the UN inspectors have to have time to give their report. The British now being required, I think, to give two different votes in the House of Commons, one today, one sometime next week, and therefore a whole lot of politics beginning, which is going to be, I think, holding back any possible military action for some time to come, it seems.
And where does this leave Barack Obama? He seems to have painted himself into a corner with his red lines.
Frankly, I think President Obama has painted himself into a corner, and not in the last few weeks, but all the way back to a year ago when he made that first statement about the use of chemical weapons by the Assad regime constituting a red line. He said that, and then, of course, it's become clear in the course of the last 3 or 4 months, there have been a number of occasions on which Assad has used chemical weapons. Now on August 21st, I think it was the big one in eastern Ghouta, 350 people dead. And it's much harder for the president now to find his way out of that. And I think it's interesting to see even the people who he thought were his closest allies on this, the French and the British, also pulling back, leaving the president to some degree by himself in the territory.
Okay, we are in Israel. There are concerns here. There have been queues for gas masks and the like. Mm. What are the chances of Israel being sucked into any conflict, perhaps at the very least in the beginning, by being on the receiving end of missiles from either Syria or from its proxy Hezbollah?
Israel will, of course, do everything it can to stay out of anything at all coming out of the Syrian civil war. My own sense is any likelihood depends on the nature of a US attack on Syria, because if the attack is, as it's looking like it's going to be, a short a burst, a single sort of punitive action against Syria, that means Assad won't be frightened of his regime falling as a result of it. He won't be frightened of America entering the Syrian civil war on the side of the rebels. He'll therefore still think he can win the civil war, as he currently thinks, and that will, I think, be a deterrent from him from bringing Israel in, because if he does bring Israel in, that will, of course, change the balance of forces very much on the ground to the detriment of the Syrian regime.
Okay, Jonathan Speier, Senior Research Fellow at the Interdisciplinary Centre in Herzliya, just north of Tel Aviv. Thanks for your analysis there on the situation here regarding Syria and, of course, Israel's position in what is or isn't going to happen. Guy.
Elliot Gotkin in Tel Aviv, thank you very much indeed.